10 minutes after 11. 50 minutes until the start of 2017. And I'm gonna bring in the New Year's for the very first time in my life by myself. And that's cool. I ain't mad about it because I'm out here doing what I want to do to, as y'all already know, further my agenda and, get myself and my family into that financially stable and prosperous situation that I've been, that pretty much catapulted me to come out here on the road. So it's all gravy. Spoke with my lady about it, and my grandmother, my mother, and one of my younger brothers about it not too long ago, each of them individually when I called them on the phone and told them, I ain't really heard about it, I'm doing what I want to do, I'm actually happy about it. This time last year, I was just thinking about coming to OTR, I was just starting to research it and look into it and see how I could do it where it'd be worthwhile to do it at home. If I was really making the same amount of money I was making at home, then obviously that would be a stupid ass decision. I don't make decisions on impulse. I don't make rash decisions. Especially decisions of this magnitude, I put in the research, the time to make sure the decision I make is going to make sense. Literally, in this situation. I was just talking with my younger brother, one of my younger brothers. I'm the oldest of three. I'm the oldest of four. I got three brothers and a sister, and I'm the eldest. And I was talking to the eldest of my younger siblings. And we was talking for about an hour and some change. But anyways, we was talking about the fact that New Year's is a celebration. And me and we're talking, and it was like, but you know, what the fuck, what are you celebrating? Everybody celebrates all, bringing in the New Year's, right? And I'm celebrating the fact that I get to see another year, and I saw another year. Thank God for the year. Yes, we all should thank God for seeing another year, making it through the year that we're leaving, and then blessed to see the next year. But what did you do with that year, though? And that's where I'm getting at with my point of this is New Year's is a celebration of one or two things. And as far as I'm concerned, the second thing ties in with the first. The first thing being you're celebrating things that you were able to accomplish and get done that were productive throughout the year. So what did you do in 2016 that's worth celebrating? Second part of that is 2017. I'm celebrating the things that I am planning to accomplish and achieve and do in the upcoming year. Okay, now what are you planning on doing that in 2017 that is first and foremost reasonable? Everybody sets these lofty goals and expectations and what they're gonna do and knowing damn well they're not gonna do it. Knowing damn well they're not even going to attempt to do it. It just sounds good to say going into the new year. So, what did you accomplish? Why are you celebrating the end of 2016 if you didn't do shit in 2016? If you're leaving 2016 in the same exact situation that you entered it in, or possibly worse, what are you really celebrating for? You didn't do enough in 2016 to celebrate anything at all anyways. You know what I'm saying? So what the fuck are you really celebrating? Then, if you haven't accomplished it in 2016, what are you going to do in 2017 that's going to be different? Are you actually going to put forth an effort to accomplish whatever it is that you claim you want to do? Because if you're not, then what are you celebrating that for? What are you celebrating for, in terms of the future of the upcoming year? What are you celebrating for if you're not going to do shit that year? And you know you're not. Too many people talk that new year, new me shit. I'm about to go on a diet. I'm about to save up money. I'm about to get my credit fixed. I'm about to, you know, start this. I'm going to start a company. I'm going to go into business for myself. And I would say confidently that 80% of those people have no intentions of following through with said goal. Or whatever you want to, however you want to refer to it as, a goal, a plan, whatever. First of all, no, it's not a plan, it's a goal. Because if you're really going to do something, if you really are consciously going to put forth the effort to do whatever it is that you set as a goal for yourself, then you develop a plan. So if there's a plan, then that's the first step to consciously working toward accomplishing something. If you don't ever set up a plan, then you're just talking. And as the saying goes, talk is cheap. So, if you didn't do shit in 2016, you ended 2016 the same exact way you ended you began it. Unless, of course, you began 2016 as a prosperous person. If you began 2016 as a person who was in business for themselves, and in 2015 you made six figures, and in 2016 you made six figures again, well, you can celebrate for the consistency. You are consistently making six figures, you are consistently being productive, and you are consistently being financially prosperous. Round of applause to you. We all know the type of people I'm talking about. If you're not supporting yourself, if you're living at home with your mother, your father, your parents, a relative, if you're living with some friends, if you're living off some friends, if you're bouncing around from one house to the next because you don't have one to call your own, because you don't have the work ethic, you don't have the self-determination to even just take care of yourself, what are you celebrating? Why are you out here turning up, getting drunk, spending a little bit of money you got at a club, at a bar, at a house party? What the fuck are you doing? Your mindset is just, you need to be saving a little bit of dollars you do got, because you're going to need them. If you're in that situation, you don't need to be wasting any money at all. If you don't even got, not necessarily a house, an apartment, you know what I mean, renting out a basement. If you can't even rent a room where you can say, look, I'm paying rent for this room, and I'm starting from here, I'm renting a room, I'm stacking up money, I'm saving money up so I can get an apartment. Cool. If you're not even doing that, what the fuck are you doing? Spending a little bit of money you do got, turning up somewhere, getting drunk, getting high. What are you doing? You're wasting a little bit of money you got, and you're wasting time. And time is precious. Motherfuckers, years keep going by. I keep seeing people my age. I'm 28, I'll be 29. July of 2017, I'll be 29. People my age, people older than me, and I can see people younger than me following that same damn path. You know, not doing shit. Cycle has to stop at some point. You know what I'm saying? You would think that a motherfucker would say enough is enough. You a 29-year-old, 30-plus-year-old, 40-something-year-old man can't even support himself. Where's your pride? You know what I'm saying? But then you got the fucking audacity to spend every weekend, or in particular this weekend, turning up, celebrating, accomplishing jack shit, wasting a little bit of money you do make on the same thing week in and week out. I mean, like, people like that, y'all turn up every fucking weekend anyways. Those are people, they always, every time the weekend, they gotta go party somewhere. I mean, so what makes this week, the 52nd week of the year, any different than the other 51 weeks? Just because it's New Year's, now you feel like you have a reason to go out and turn up, I guess? I don't know. It's just another fucking weekend as far as I'm concerned. Tomorrow is Sunday. And the date on that is going to be 1-1-2017. That's it. That's the only difference. as far as I'm concerned, you know, I'm not saying you shouldn't celebrate the new year or, you know, whatever. You should. But you need to do things accordingly. If you haven't accomplished it, what the fuck are you celebrating? Like I've said several times throughout this video. Going into this new year, what I've accomplished. Now, I was working full time, supporting my family, making enough money to keep my head above water. That was something to celebrate. Thank God that I had that job. Thank God that my son didn't want or need for anything. I did not have to beg, borrow, or steal. I made enough money to make sure he got what he needed. That's something to celebrate. And that wasn't enough for me. So what I'm celebrating now is the fact that I came out here, I took that step out, as they say, step out on faith. I took that leap. I came out here. I got my LLC started. I'm officially a business owner, and I'm officially running my own business. I leased the truck, albeit through Prime. I leased the truck. I'm making the payments on this truck, so I got my truck. I got my business account and business savings account set up. That is what I celebrate going into 2017. Those are goals that I set up once I decided that this is the step I wanted to take. And I accomplished those goals. So going into 2017, what am I celebrating? From what I did in 2016, I'm celebrating the fact that I was able to continue supporting my family. And I've accomplished the first phase of my plan along this journey to business ownership in the truck industry. That's what I celebrate going for. Going into 2017, what am I celebrating? I'm celebrating the fact that what I am going to do, not what I'm hoping to do, not what I, you know, wish to do, what I am going to do is, one, get my business credit established, Paydex score, all that, get all that established, and in good standards, and in great standards. 1B, repair my personal credit. Okay? 2, business credit, personal credit. Two is I'm gonna get credit line for business. I'm gonna get a business credit line. Okay. Three is I'm gonna save as much money as I possibly can. But the goal I wrote down is to save this time next year. I'm gonna have no less than $10,000 in my business checking or business savings or a combination of the two. I'm gonna have no less than $10,000 just sitting there. And I think that's lowballing. Especially if I get myself in a situation where I start training, that's really lowballing. I should be able to save up at least $20,000 by the end of the 2017 fiscal year. Those are my three goals that I have for this year. The three main goals. And those goals will be accomplished. I wrote them down. They will be accomplished. I'm not talking just to talk, just because it sounds good. Somebody pat me on the back. That's a good plan you got there, man. I hope, you know, it works out for you. Ain't no hoping. It's going to work out. It's going to happen. I'm going to make it happen. So that's what I celebrate going into 2017. That's just what was on my mind after I had the conversation with my little brother, man. Motherfuckers be so gung-ho to celebrate and just basically get fucked up, get drunk, get high in the name of whatever it may be. I mean, motherfuckers do that shit just in the name of Friday. Oh, God, it's Friday. Let's go get drunk. It's Saturday. Let's go turn up. How much money are you wasting doing that shit? If you can't afford to waste that money, then you're fucking stupid. That's how I look at it. I mean, that's just how I look at it. You know, if I can't afford to go out and waste $200 on a Friday night, $300 on a Friday night, why would I do that? And then you got the ones out here partying on the budget. all you got is $50 to spend. Even then, you really don't, if you partied on a budget, then you really can't afford to just waste that $50 to $100. That money can go to something more productive, something more meaningful than just going out and spending $20-something dollars to get into a club, spending fucking $6, $7 every drink you get, buying bottles to turn up with before you get there, buying weed and all these other type of drugs you may be doing. And I ain't knocking weed. I'm pro-cannabis. Just in case y'all don't know, I don't fuck with it right now, obviously, because of my profession. But I indulged in my fair share of cannabis throughout my college years, and I don't see anything wrong with it. You know what I mean? But that's definitely another topic of discussion for another day. Anyway, I think people need to get their minds right, their priorities right. Too many people are just wasting time, wasting money just to have a good time on a weekend. Anyways, man, Happy New Year's to y'all, man. I hope y'all got goals set. I hope y'all got plans in motion or plans written down in order to accomplish those goals. I hope that y'all go out there and do what y'all got to make it happen, man. Work hard to accomplish it. Grind hard, stay focused on the end goal. Do what you gotta do to make this shit happen, man. You know, so I wish y'all well, wish y'all a happy New Year's, man, and I'ma keep trucking on for another hour or so, pull on over and drink a bottle of water and celebrate my my new year, my 2017 again. My 2016 gonna end with me hauling the load. 2017 gonna begin with me delivering that load and getting another load. So my year is ending getting money, it's beginning getting money, and this is just the beginning. So as always, y'all know, stay up, stay safe. I'ma do my best to do the same thing. Until next time, it's your man JMV. Once again, Happy New Year's, man. Y'all be safe.